Okay, so this time we're going to discuss about managing knowledge. No? Knowledge management in collaboration systems are two of the most rapidly expanding areas of corporate and government software investment. So the last decades has seen an explosion in knowledge and knowledge management research in the domains of economics, management, and of course, information system. Collaboration and knowledge management are inextricably linked. No? Knowledge that cannot be transmitted and shared with others is almost worthless. When knowledge is shared throughout the organization, it becomes useful and actionable. Collaboration system, as covered in this discussion, no, in this subject or discourse, include internet-based collaboration environments such as Google Sites, IBM Lotus Notes, social networking, email, and instant messaging, even virtual meeting system like Wikis and virtual words. No, in this lesson, no, we will look or concentrate on knowledge management system, keeping in mind that communicating and sharing knowledge is become increasingly vital. We live in an information economy, and where the production and distribution of information and knowledge is the primary source of income and prosperity. And to give us more details about the topic, let us all welcome our presenter. Go ahead.
Blessed morning po sa amin ni Ma'am Christina, and blessed afternoon po sa ating pong lahat. This is Rowena Villanueva Lumandas. I was tasked to present to you on Chapter 11 entitled Managing Knowledge. But before that, let me discuss the course intended learning outcomes. At the end of the module, we, the students, are expected to comprehend the function of knowledge management and programs for knowledge management in business, to list and describe the many kind of systems used for enterprise-wide knowledge management, and explain how they benefit enterprises. To understand the main categories and knowledge work systems and how they can benefit businesses, and to understand the advantages of employing intelligent methods for knowledge management from commercial perspective. Let me introduce to you the topic. Let's break down the knowledge management landscape into its key components, including important dimensions of knowledge, the knowledge management value chain, and the types of knowledge management systems. Knowledge management has become an important theme at many large business firms, as managers realize that much of their firm's value depends on the firm's ability to create and manage knowledge. Studies has found that a substantial part of a firm's stock market value is related to its intangible assets, of which knowledge is one important component, along with brands, reputations, and unique business processes. Well-executed knowledge-based projects have been known to produce extraordinary returns on investment, although the impacts of knowledge-based investments are difficult to measure. According to Dr. Miles Monroe, knowledge is actually information. So let us look into the knowledge management landscape. The knowledge management landscape refers to the various strategies, the processes, tools, and approaches that organizations use to capture, organize, store, retrieve, and share knowledge effectively. Knowledge management, therefore, is crucial for improving decision-making, innovation, and overall organizational performance. There are actually important dimensions of knowledge. There is an important distinction between data, information, knowledge, and wisdom. To transform information into knowledge, a firm must expend additional resources to discover patterns, rules, and contexts where the knowledge works. Wisdom is taught to be the collective and individual experience of applying knowledge to the solution of problems. In short, wisdom is the application of knowledge. It involves where, when, and how to apply knowledge. So knowledge is both an individual attribute and a collective attribute of the firm. It is a cognitive, even a physiological event that takes place inside the people's heads. It is also stored in the libraries and records shared in lectures and stored by firms in the form of business processes and employee know-how. Ibig sabihin, knowledge is an asset of a firm. It is an intangible asset. The transformation of data into useful information and knowledge requires organizational resources. Knowledge is not subject to the law of diminishing returns as are physical assets, but instead experiences network effects as its value increases as more people share it. There are different forms of knowledge, which you can see that are listed in there. There are actually six. We have the explicit, the tacit, structured, unstructured, internal, and external. The explicit knowledge is the knowledge that can easily be codified and documented. Example po nito are the manuals, itong mga reports natin, databases, and written procedures. While tacit knowledge is, it is difficult to articulate and is often based sa mga personal pong experiences, kaisipan, at intuition. Katulad halimbawa, the expertise of a seasoned employee or the skills of a craftsman. Structured knowledge naman po are information that is organized in a logical and systematic manner. For instance, yung kanina dinidiscuss yung mga well-organized na databases. Those are called structured knowledge. Pag sinabi mo naman na unstructured, these are, of course, information and expertise that lacks, rather, a specific organization or structure. Example are emails, social media posts, and even chat logs. Pagdating naman sa internal knowledge, these are informations and expertise that resides within the organization, katulad ng kaalaman ng empleyado at yung mga proprietary data. External knowledge naman are the knowledge that exists outside. From the word external, it's from outside the organization. This includes industry reports, market trends, and publicly available information. The knowledge management value chain. The knowledge management value refers to the set of business processes developed in an organization to create, to store, to transfer, and apply knowledge. Knowledge management increases the ability of organization to learn from its environment and to incorporate into its business processes. The figure 11.1 illustrates the five value adding steps in the knowledge management value change. So makikita po natin that it's a stage in the value chain adds value doon po sa mga raw data and information as they are transformed into usable knowledge. The knowledge management value chain comprises several stages. It's contributing to the effective management and utilization of knowledge. So meron po tayong create, this generate a new knowledge, or capture existing knowledge. Katulad halimbawa, you are about to conduct or you have to conduct a customer survey para makagather ka ng feedback towards improvement or the betterment ng mga ginagawa ng isang organization. Then is the next one is store. Safely store knowledge in repositories, databases, or content management systems. For example, yun nga yung kanina, using a cloud-based storage system para sa mga document management ng organization. After that, you have stored the informations, the knowledge, you have to organize it. Structure and categorize knowledge for easy retrieval. Pagka-organize kasi, mas madali mo siyang mare-retrieve pag kinailangan mo siya. So this may involve creating taxonomies, metadata, or knowledge maps. Then when you retrieve them, you make the knowledge accessible when needed. This could be through search engines or intelligent algorithms. Next is transfer. Facilitate the knowledge sharing among employees or stakeholders. For example, you are going to organize the training sessions or create a mentorship programs para ma-transfer mo yung knowledge. Then of course, after transferring the knowledge, there's a need for application. So you will implement the knowledge, una to solve problems, to make decisions, or to innovate. And this involves putting knowledge to practical use. After the application, you do have the evaluation. Assess the effectiveness of the knowledge management efforts. Use analytics to measure impact and identify areas of improvements. Let's move to the types of knowledge management systems. There are essentially three major types of management of knowledge management systems. Number one is the enterprise-wide knowledge management systems. General purpose is to integrate firm-wide efforts to collect, store, disseminate, and use digital content and knowledge. Dito, enterprise content management systems, collaboration and social tools, learning management systems, knowledge network systems are involved. Meron din pong knowledge work systems. Ito naman is specialized workstations and systems that enable scientists, engineers, and other knowledge workers to create and discover new knowledge. This includes the CAD, which is known as the computer-aided design. Meron po silang tinatawag na 3D virtualization, virtual reality, the investment workstations. At ang pangatlo po is yung intelligent techniques. Dito naman tools for discovering patterns and applying knowledge to discrete decisions and knowledge domain. This includes data mining, neural networks, expert systems, case-based reasoning, fuzzy logic, genetic algorithms, intelligent agents. These three major categories of knowledge management systems, and each can be broken down further into more specialized types of knowledge management systems. Kaya sa pagdating po ng 11.2, we will be able to understand what is the enterprise-wide knowledge management systems. Enterprise-wide knowledge management systems, otherwise known as KMS, are comprehensive systems and strategies that organizations implement to efficiently capture, store, organize, share, and access knowledge and information across the entire organization. These systems facilitate the creation of knowledge sharing, culture, and improve decision-making, innovation, and productivity. Ano naman po yung Enterprise Content Management System? Ito naman, otherwise known as ECM, are comprehensive software solutions and strategies that organizations use to capture, store, manage, organize, retrieve, and distribute various types of content and documents across the entire enterprise. These systems play a critical role in information governance, compliance, and improving organizational efficiency. Take a look at Figure 11.3. It is entitled an Enterprise Content Management System. Dito po, makikita po natin that an enterprise management system has capabilities for classifying, organizing, and managing structured and semi-structured knowledge and making it available throughout the enterprise. Napaka self-explanatory po niya. So I will not be digging too much on that. Let's move to the next slide, please. The knowledge network systems. The knowledge network systems, or KNS, are specialized information systems designed to facilitate the creation, sharing, and management of knowledge and information within an organization or amongst a network of organizations. These systems are crucial for collaboration, again, for decision making, and of course, for innovation. Collaboration and social tools and learning management systems. Actually, in chapter 2 and 7, this has already been discussed. The importance of collaboration and social tools for information sharing within the firm. So companies need ways to keep track of and manage employee learning and to integrate it more fully into their knowledge management and other corporate systems. A learning management system, or LMS, provide tools for the management, delivery, tracking and assessment of various types of employee learning and training. So knowledge network systems are specialized information. So ano naman yung knowledge work systems? The enterprise-wide knowledge systems we have just described provide a wide range of capabilities that can be used by many, if not all, workers and groups in an organization. Firms also have specialized systems for knowledge workers to help them create new knowledge and to ensure that this knowledge is properly integrated into the business. The knowledge workers and the knowledge work. Knowledge workers, including researchers, designers, architects, scientists, and engineers, are individuals within an organization responsible for creating knowledge and information. Kaya bear in mind that you, as an engineer, sa mga classmates po natin dyan, engineers, architects, designers, you are responsible for creating knowledge information. They typically possess high levels of education, often hold memberships in professional organizations, and regularly exercise independent judgment in their work. For instance, they contribute to the development of new products or the enhancement of existing ones. Kaya ang tinatawag na knowledge workers, they actually play three vital roles within the organization. And they are listed here. Una, as a knowledge worker, you keep the organization informed about the external developments in knowledge, spanning technology, science, social thought, and the arts. Kapag may bago, bilang knowledge worker, it is your responsibility to inform what is happening in the outside and what is going on in the world within the organization. At ang pangalawa, you act as an internal consultant, offering, of course, your expertise. Wag mong ipagdamot yung expertise mo, yung knowledge mo, and your know-how in your respective area of knowledge and keeping the organization updated on changes and opportunities. At ang pangatlo, you contribute significantly to the organization's growth and innovation by applying your specialized skills and knowledge to various projects and initiatives. Ganun po kahalaga at kaimportante ang isang knowledge worker at ang kanyang maitutulong sa kampanyang kanya pong kinabibilangan. So there are requirements of a knowledge work systems. Most knowledge workers rely on office technology meant to boost workers' productivity, hindi lamang sa opisina, katulad ng word processors, voicemail, video conferencing, and scheduling systems. Ang knowledge workers, on the other hand, necessitate highly specialized knowledge work systems with strong visuals, analytical tools, and communication and document management capabilities. Figure 11.4 shows the requirements of knowledge work systems. So mula sa external knowledge base, magkakaroon po ng software. Yung mga graphics, visualization, modeling, simulation, document management, communications, transferred sa user interface, diba? Mula doon sa hardware platform or mula sa knowledge workstation. So knowledge work systems requires strong links to external knowledge bases in addition to specialized hardware and software. Knowledge work systems or KWS are specialized information systems designed to support knowledge workers in various fields. They require a combination of hardware, software, data resources, procedures, skilled human resources, of course. Kailangan po talaga yan. Feedback mechanisms, control measures, and a supportive organizational culture to enable knowledge workers to create, manage, and share knowledge, of course, effectively. These systems are essential sa bawat organisasyon o kumpanyang atin pong kinabibilangan that rely on knowledge-intensive activities katulad ng research, ng design, ng innovation, and data analysis. What are the examples of knowledge work systems? In Figure 11.2, meron po tayo dyan examples na nakalagay. Una dyan is yung CAD o CAM, Computer-Aided Manufacturing, which provides engineers, designers, and factory managers with precise control over industrial design and manufacturing. Actually, I'm not very familiar with this. I'm not an engineer by profession. And then meron din po tayong virtual reality systems. These provide drug designers, architects, again engineers, and medical workers with precise photorealistic simulations of objects. And the third one, investing workstations, high-end pieces used in the financial sector to analyze trading situations instantaneously and facilitate portfolio management. Now let's move to intelligent techniques. Artificial intelligence, better yet known as AI, and database technology offer various intelligent techniques for organizations to capture, expand, and manage their knowledge base. Itong mga technique na ito, they actually include yung tinatawag pong is expert systems, case-based reasoning, fuzzy logic for capturing tacit knowledge, and neural networks, data mining, and genetic algorithms for knowledge discovery and problem solving. Intelligent agents automate routine tasks, aiding in activities like electronic commerce and supply chain management. Yung data mining, which was introduced earlier, helps us uncover hidden knowledge within large databases, providing valuable insights for improving business performance and aiding management decision making. AI-based techniques, while not replicating human intelligence, are essential tools in contemporary knowledge management, as they emulate human behaviors, support decision-making, and automate tasks critical for organizational efficiency and innovation. Let's move to capturing knowledge expert systems. Expert systems are software systems that capture tacit knowledge in a specific domain of human expertise. These systems, they store the knowledge of skilled employees as a set of rules, adding to the firm's memory. They typically perform limited tasks, such as diagnosing malfunctioning machines or determining loan credit. However, they can help organizations make high-quality decisions with fewer people. Expert systems model human knowledge as a set of interconnected roles, allowing computers to process complex problems. Figure 11.5 shows the rules in an expert system. An expert system contains number of rules to be followed. The rules are interconnected. The number of outcomes is known in advance and is limited. And there are multiple paths to the same outcome. And the system can consider multiple rules at a single time. So yung mga rules illustrated are simple credit granting expert systems. You can just go over later on. And let's move to the organizational intelligence case-based reasoning. Organizational intelligence refers to the capacity of an organization to collect, analyze, and utilize information and knowledge effectively to achieve its goals and make informed decisions. Case-based reasoning, or CVR, is one of the techniques employed in organizational intelligence to facilitate problem-solving and decision-making processes. If you take a look at figure 11.6, we can see how case-based reasoning works. So this case-based reasoning represents knowledge as a database of past cases and their solutions. The system uses 6-step process to generate solutions to new problems encountered by the user. These are: user describes the problem, the system searches database for similar cases. Pag nakakita siya ng similar cases, it moves to asking the user additional question para ma-narrow down yung search niya. Then, magkakaroon siya ng, he will find the closest fit and retrieves solution. Then the system modifies the solution to better fit the problem. And finally, the system stores the problem and a successful solution in the database. Now, let's take a look at the fuzzy logic system. Kanina ko pa ito paulit-ulit na sinasabi. Fuzzy logic system, or FLS, is a type of artificial intelligence and mathematical framework that extends classical binary logic by allowing the degrees of truth between 0 and 1. Unlike traditional binary logic, where the statement is either true or false, ito namang fuzzy logic allows the intermediate values which make it suitable for modeling and handling imprecise or uncertain information. The applications of FLS are widely used in various fields, including the control system, decision support system, pattern recognition, and artificial intelligence. They are especially useful in scenarios where imprecise or uncertain data is prevalent, such as in temperature control systems, automotive systems, and natural language processing. What are the benefits of FLS? FLS offers several advantages, including the ability to model and reason with uncertain or imprecise information, providing a more human-like approach to decision-making. They are flexible and adaptable to a wide range of applications and can handle complex, non-linear relationships. Yan po yung FLS. Yung machine learning naman, otherwise known as ML, hindi po ito yung laro ng mga bata. This is machine learning, is a subset of AI or artificial intelligence that focuses on developing algorithms and statistical models that enable computer systems to learn from and make predictions or decisions based on data. Instead of being explicitly programmed to perform a task, ML systems use data to improve their performance over time. Meron din po tayong intelligence agents. Ano naman siya? IA. Intelligent agent technology helps businesses to navigate through large amounts of data to locate and act on information that is considered important. Intelligent agents are software programs that work without direct intervention to carry out specific tasks of an individual user, business process, or software application. Figure 11.11 shows the intelligent agents in PNG supply chain network. So makikita po dyan that using intelligent agent models, PNG discovered that trucks should often be dispatched before being fully loaded. Although transportation costs would be higher using partially loaded trucks, the simulation showed that retail store stockouts would occur less often, thus reducing the amount of low sales, which would more than make up for the higher distribution costs. Agent-based modeling has saved PNG $300. $300 million rather annually and an investment of less than 1% of that amount. Ayan. So intelligent agents are helping PNG shorten the replenishment cycles for products katulad ng box of Tide na naandyan po sa ating pong example. Now we do have the last one. I'm not going to prolong our agony of waiting to finish this chapter. We have the hybrid AI systems. They are advanced artificial intelligence systems that combine multiple AI techniques and approaches to address complex problems or tasks. These systems integrate the strengths of different AI methods to leverage their complementary capabilities. Hybrid AI systems are designed to perform more effectively and robustly than single AI system in a wide range of applications. Next slide, please. I can never thank you enough for giving me the time and for listening to my report. Listed in here are my references. Thank you and have a blessed day.
Okay, so thank you so much, Madam, no? And good morning, as what you have mentioned, no? So again, knowledge management is a set of processes used in organizations to create, store, transfer, and utilize knowledge. Much of our organization's value is determined by its ability to create and manage knowledge. Now, knowledge management foster organizational learning by improving the organization's ability to learn from its surroundings and apply knowledge to its business processes. So enterprise-wide knowledge management system, knowledge work system, and intelligent approaches are three major types of knowledge management system. On the other hand, enterprise-wide knowledge management system are initiatives to gather, store, disseminate, and apply digital content and knowledge across an organization. So databases and the tools for organizing and storing structured documents as well as tools for organizing and storing semi-structured documents, no? Such as tools for organizing and storing semi-structured knowledge such as email or rich media are provided by enterprise content management. So knowledge work systems provide directories and tools for locating, no? Business employees with specialized knowledge who are valuable providers of tacit information. And this system frequently incorporate group collaboration tools, portals to improve information access, search capabilities, and tools for categorizing information based on the acceptable taxonomy for the organization. So enterprise-wide knowledge management system can deliver significant value if they are correctly designed and enable employees to more efficiently locate, exchange, and apply the knowledge, as I mentioned. Now, okay. Knowledge management system, no, facilitate the generation of new knowledge and its incorporation into organizations. So knowledge work system necessitates simple access to an external knowledge base, a strong computer hardware capable of supporting software with heavy graphics, analysis, document management, and communication capabilities. And an intuitive user interface. So graphics and strong modeling capabilities are required, no, to computer-aided design systems, no, augmented reality apps, and virtual reality system, which produce interactive simulation and that behave like the actual world. No, PWS for financial professionals provide access to other databases as well as the capacity to quickly evaluate vast amounts of financial data. Artificial intelligence lacks humans' intelligence flexibility, breadth, and generality, but it can be used to capture, no, codify, and extend organizational knowledge. An expert system extracts tacit information from a narrow domain of human skills and represent it as rules. No, expert system are especially useful for categorization and diagnostic diagnosis difficulties. Case-based reasoning defects organizational knowledge as a database of example that may be developed and enhanced on ongoing basis. No? We have, of course, what we called a neural networks, genetic algorithms, and intelligent agents. No? So the neural network, or we have also what we call PASI logic. No? PASI logic is a software technology, as our presenter mentioned, that uses appropriate or subjective values to express information in the form of rules. So PASI logic has previously, of course, utilized to regulate physical devices and is now being employed to restricted decision-making application. On the other hand, neural networks naman are made up of hardware and software that try to replicate the cognitive process of the human brain. So therefore, human neural networks are remarkable for their capacity to learn without programming and discovering patterns that people find difficult to express. And they are used to distinguish patterns in huge amount of data and research, medicine, and business. Now, genetic algorithms use genetic processes such as fitness, no, crossover, and mutation to solve specific issues. And genetic algorithms are being used to solve optimization of product design and monitoring industrial system challenges where many alternatives or variables must be considered in order to develop an ideal solution. Intelligent agents are software programs that have pre-programmed or learned knowledge base that perform particular repetitive and predictable tasks for a single user, business process, or software application. So intelligent agent now can be programmed to search through enormous volumes of data for relevant information and in some situations to act on that information on the user's behalf. So I think that's it for this module. Okay, next presenter.